In this tutorial, I'll demonstrate some of the many text features available in PaintShop Pro 2018. Specifically, I'll cover creating and formatting text, moving, sizing, and rotating text, editing text and its properties, text presets, and filling text with an image. I'm going to start by adding text to an existing image. I have PaintShop Pro open to the Edit workspace, and I have my organizer open, which you can do in the Palettes menu. I'm searching in PaintShop Pro's sample images. These can be found in the folder called Samples, where you have PaintShop Pro installed. I'm dragging this one into the editor. Then I'll click the push pin to minimize the organizer. The text tool is this icon down here. The interactive property bar lists all of the various text options I have. I'm choosing a font and size. Font color sets the fill, and stroke color is for the text outlines, and can be changed by clicking these swatches or by clicking the swatches in the Materials palette. In this example, the fill will be transparent, and I'll change the stroke to match the flowers. I can adjust the stroke width here. I'll use 10 for letter outlines that will be easy to see. I want to create this text as a vector so that it can easily be edited later. I'm clicking on the image approximately where I want the text to go and typing. Then I'll click Apply to finish, or I can double click. The text string is placed on its own layer, and you can tell it's a vector layer by this icon. After text is created, I can move or resize it. I can use the drag handles to widen or stretch. I can move it by dragging this handle, and I can rotate it with this one. Incidentally, moving and resizing can also be done when the pick tool is active and a text string is selected. Because the text is a vector, I can go back and change any of its properties or change the text itself. I can click in the string and change the words, or I can highlight some of the letters and change their font. Double-clicking ends the editing, which leaves the text still selected. I can give this entire text string a fill by clicking the font color swatch. On the Pattern tab, I'm choosing this fill pattern. Or, if I want to use a fill pattern of my own, I just have to have the image open in PaintShop Pro. I'll open this image, which is also in the Samples folder. When I go to change the fill pattern, that image is now listed. But I can still make changes, like reducing the pattern scale. Now let's look at text presets. The text is still selected, so whatever preset I choose will get applied to this string. To see the included presets, I'm clicking this icon. There are several to choose from, and at the end of the list are some presets you can download for free. I'm applying this one called Rainbow. This preset has a stroke width of zero thickness, so the edges don't appear. The fill is a color gradient, which could be adjusted with these settings. Or I can switch to a solid color. Or I can add texture to the color. I can add edges by adding a stroke width and making the edges a solid color. I'm double-clicking to end the editing and using Ctrl-Z to return to my original text style. I'm going to rotate it to be straight again. And instead of this pattern, I want this landscape gradient with no texture. Double-click to end the editing. Say that now I want to save this text style to use in the future. My text is selected, and all of the correct settings are listed along the property bar. I'm clicking the presets icon, being careful not to pass my cursor over any others in the list, and clicking the save icon. I'm assigning a name, and now the text preset appears in the list. This text preset is available for download from Corel's Discovery Center, where this tutorial can be found. Now I'm going to turn off my text layer and show another text feature. Wrapping text is when text automatically fits inside a vector shape. In the Layers palette, I'll add a new vector layer for this shape. I'm going to my Preset Shape tool, clicking the Shapes list, and in the All category, finding the heart. I'm unchecking Retain Style so that fill will be applied, and setting a solid fill. Dragging from corner to corner creates the heart. Now I'll add one more vector layer for the new text. The text itself will come from outside PaintShop Pro, say from a website or from a document. I can copy that text with Ctrl+C. Here in PaintShop, I'll activate text, set a simple script font, reduce the size to fit, and set a transparent stroke and solid white fill. When my cursor is inside the shape, I get a pair of brackets, which means text will stay inside the shape. When I click inside the shape to start the text, the cursor jumps to the top of the heart. Then I can right-click and choose Paste, and double-click to finish. Whatever doesn't fit goes outside the heart. The other option is Paste to Fit, which adjusts the font size so that the entire text fits. I'll turn off these layers and add just one more, called Text Cutout, to show another fun thing to do with text. This will show how to make text cutouts filled with an image. I'm creating a new text string using my Spring preset. I'm placing the text down here, over the flowers, and adjusting the size to cover more of the flowers in the photo. To see what the filled text will look like, click the Cutter Preview icon. The edges and fill disappear, and I can still make adjustments to the text itself. Then I'll click Text Cutter. This creates a new image with the filled text on a transparent background. I can drag this layer onto any background, like the one in my original photo or any other image. And with my Pick tool, I can move the text to where I want it. The original text is still there, but its layer was automatically hidden when the text was cut. Here's another way to do something similar. I'm in the Text tool again, but this time creating it as a selection. I'm adding my text where I want the image to appear. Then I click Apply Changes. This creates a filled section on its own raster layer, which I can move anywhere with the Pick tool. And while this layer is selected, I can use the Effects, 3D Effects options to make the text really stand out, such as with this drop shadow. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on working with text in PaintShop Pro. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along, get the download link for the text preset, and many other helpful tutorials for Corel PaintShop Pro.